April 8, 1884. A terrible end. Additional particulars of the death of Henry A. Dewey. The Fordian correspondent of the Star sends the following additional particulars of the death of Henry A. Dewey. About 6:30 the Sunday morning, B. Bailey, while walking on the railroad track, discovered the body of a man lying on the ties between the rails on the bridge over the canal. His body was terribly mutilated, being minus an arm and a foot, the chest torn open, exposing what remained of the vitals. All the upper portion of the head was also gone. And in parentheses, just reading this is like, wow. Let's see here. And let's see. Was also gone, and no clothing except one boot and one sock and part of the pants and drawers. Appearances indicated that the body had been drawn a long distance by the cars. It was evidently dropped by the northbound freight train about 4:00 this morning. Frank Coon and others followed up the track, finding pieces of clothing and particulars of the bone and flesh scattered along the track. About 2 miles south of Brayton's Crossing. I'm from there, I don't really recognize that, but part of a foot and boot were found. And further on, part of a coat, letters, and papers, also a watch, knife, and pieces of the skull and brain. By the papers, it was ascertained that the body was that of Henry A. Dewey of Smith's Basin. The last named articles found were a few rods. A few rods north of the victim's house, which is not far from the railroad. Coroner O.C. Burroughs of Whitehall was notified, and A.C. Vaughn placed in charge of the remains. The coroner arrived about 2:00 and immediately impaneled the following jury: Willis Witt Foreman, James Doran, D.P. Carter, L.L. Barnard, A. Grant, J. Ashley, John Kenneth, M. Bailey, James Nelson, Walter Stewart, Ezra Belden. The following facts were ascertained. Sorry, it's a long article, though. Mr. Dewey left home Wednesday morning for Cohoes, Albany, and several other places on business. He wrote his wife from Cohoes that he would be home Saturday night if he got through with his business. It is thought he came to Fort Edward on the sleeper, then started for home on foot on the track and was struck by a freight train, or that he came up on the freight and, while attempting to get off, was caught and killed. Just how this accident occurred remains a mystery and perhaps ever will. The missing arm was found caught in the train when it arrived in Whitehall. There was no evidence of foul play, as his pocketbook containing $30 was found in his pocket. Mr. Dewey and his brother A.C. Dewey lived on the farm near Smith's Basin, which they let out on shares. Deceased was agent for farm machinery. The jury adjourned to the call of the coroner. Mr. Dewey was 41 years of age and leaves a wife and one child who had the sympathy of the entire community. He was a man of good habits and Christian principles. His funeral will take place next Wednesday. The remains will be interred in the cemetery at Fort Ann. Holy crap. Mr. Dewey may have had a premonition. And I'm not making this up. This is in the paper. This is from April 10th, 1884, the Post Star. Henry Dewey's presentiment. It will be remembered that in the Star's report of the terrible death of Henry A. Dewey of Fort Ann, reference was made to the fact he had just returned from Syracuse. The journal of that place has the following: The account in Monday's Journal of the terrible death of Henry Dewey, a farmer of Fort Ann, Washington County, was seen by Cyrus D. Avery, who gives us the singular details of a remarkable presentiment that Mr. Dewey had of his impending sudden death. Mr. Dewey came here on Friday last and stopped on the way over the day and night with his cousin, Dr. W.W. Porter in Geddes. I've never heard of Geddes, but okay. Saturday morning, he made a purchase of a carload of manure spreaders. They're hard to explain, but basically you hooked them up to the back of a horse, whatever, and, you know, they spread manure. In conversation with Mr. Avery, with whom he conducted his business, he stated that In conversation with Mr. Avery, with whom he conducted his business, he stated that he labored under a very strong depression caused by an apprehension of sudden death, that he left home against that he left home let me see, against the protest of his wife, who sympathized with his fears that he could not shake off the feeling of depression that possessed him. And in his purchase of the machines, Mr. Dewey expressly stipulated that in case of harm befalling him, his family should not be held for the purchase. The machines were to have been shipped to Mr. Dewey on Monday, but before this could be done, a telegram was received announcing his death. So he had a premonition of his death, of something bad happening. Wow. All right. From the Post Star, April 12th, 1884. The remains of Henry A. Dewey were buried in Fort Ann Cemetery April 9th. There was a very large gathering of friends and relatives at the funeral. Reverend Mr. Wright preached from the text, "There is but a step between me and death." Sadly appropriate, I think. The coroner's jury in the case of Henry A. Dewey met at the Fort Ann House April 9th and returned a verdict that Henry A. Dewey came to his death April 6th by jumping from the sleeper and being run over by the freight train, that his death was caused by carelessness on his part, and there was no... and there was no blame attached to anyone. Yeah. So basically, it was a stupid accident. And, wow. Again, I didn't want to think of that. I mean, that sounds so horrible. And it affects me just thinking about it. Of course, I'm having a strange day anyways. But there you go. Henry A. Dewey accidentally killed himself by stepping off a train, I think, in the middle of the night, or somehow being too close to the train when it started up, and somehow getting caught in it and dragged. Wow. Quick one. And there are several Henry Deweys. Apparently, if you're named Henry Dewey, you have a rough life, I think, but there's another Henry Dewey I can do a little... Henry Dewey I can do something on, which I still don't know if he's dead or not. But anyways, this is from the Post Star, April 3rd, 1886. William Wood has taken Henry Dewey's farm near Smith Basin. He moved yesterday. So I guess I had to sell the farm.